The Kennewick Man. The discovery of the Kennewick Man remains by two students in late July 1996 on the banks of the Columbia River sparked a huge controversy over who actually owned the remains. The claims came from all sides, from the Native Americans, the scientists, the Army Corps, etc. The list was long, and there was no clear answer. The identity of and the religion of the remains was an unknown puzzle to explore. After further investigation, it was noted that this set of remains was over 9,000 years old. Later, that estimation was narrowed down to about 8,500 years old. The body suggested that it lived in a rough time, with multiple injuries that had never healed correctly, and a spear tip lodged in his hip. The big controversy, however, was about the origin of this set of remains. James Chatters, after examining the remains, claimed that it was not Native American and, in fact, a descendant from Caucasoid or Caucasian family. This was not taken well by the Native Americans, who had been treated poorly in the past. The government decided it was going to hand over the remains back to the Native Americans, but this sparked outrage and a series of lawsuits to be put forth. The suits were that the Native Americans had no real proof that these remains were in any way related to them at all, and especially with the claim from Chatters that this was Caucasian. Therefore, the scientists had a valid reason for study. However, this was not the first case, nor will it be the last, of the question that if a body is found on specific lands that are labeled tribe lands, what is the process and where to begin to determine who it belongs to? In the past, there were certain incidents that were not pleasant on either side of the racial and religious divide that caused this distrust from the Native Americans. In the 1880s, when the museums first started up, they looked to those who were close to the indigenous people to obtain specimens for their exhibits. Many took to the hills looking for fresh graves and stealing the skulls off the corpses. There were even those who resorted to fights just to pull the head off an Indian after they were killed. Despite these atrocities, there were no protections put in place until the 1990s. The debate over the ownership of the Kennewick Man is more than a simple yes-no question. In my opinion, I think it belongs to the scientists up until the point they figure out who the descendants are and who it belongs to. I think that the biggest issue here is that there is no real protocol for this. If it gets authenticated as an Indian, however, then it belongs to the Native Americans and should be handed over immediately. However, until such time, it belongs to the scientists, because we have no real proof who it belongs to.